And I'm saying welcome to all of you to the session called UNaLab Urban Nature Labs with, I hope I pronounce it correctly, with our speakers, Piersaverio and Maria.
Hello.
And they will be talking today about how to learn with ICT tools for decision making in water management and in climate change adaptation. Before giving the floor to them, I just want to tell you that the session will be recorded. I am asking you to mute yourselves. And I'm also telling you that I'll be looking at the time because we have to finish on time because there will be another session following. My name is Svenja. I will be facilitating the session today. I'm from the Connecting Nature team. And after the 10-minute input, we will have the possibility, better said, you will have the possibility to ask your questions, and then you will be able to join our panel and share your video and your audio and pose your questions directly to Maria and Piersaverio. So I'm giving the floor to them now. Please start.
Thank you, Svenja. Let me share my screen. We prepared a few slides presenting the architecture. Okay. Okay, Maria. Please.
Right. Yes, thanks, Saverio. I'm going to start with some general framework. So NBS implementation comprises a set of steps from identification and prioritization of local challenges by monitoring to evidence. And evidence is the sole factor that contributes to the evidence-based decision-making for water and climate resilience of urban areas, for example. And while ICT tools are renowned for their data management, in UNaLab we came up with a set of some additional approaches where ICT tools can contribute greatly. And you can see them on the slide marked with purple circles that the ICT tools that were developed within UNaLab contribute to each step of NBS creation. Next slide, please. Yes, so given what I just said, the UNaLab ICT framework clearly facilitates the implementation of nature-based solutions and their impact assessment. And thus, it influences how climate and water resilience, climate adaptation and water resilience is addressed in the urban areas. So, Saverio, could you please tell us how the UNaLab framework supports co-creation?
Yes, thank you, Maria. Okay, the UNaLab ICT framework has been built using already existing tools, and we collected these, integrated these tools in three main functional areas. First one is the areas devoted to support the co-creation of nature-based solution. The tools permit citizen and municipality to collaborate and to exchange the information and notification about the actual problems affecting the urban environment and the possibility to solve these problems using NBS as example, but not only.
Piersaverio, there's been a comment, sorry for interrupting you, from the in the chat that it's the volume is quite low, and been asked if you could increase it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Is it better now? I try to speak loud. Okay. So the ICT framework, as I said, is composed by three main functional areas. The first one is the area supporting the co-creation. These tools facilitate the stakeholder involvement and the communication between citizens, expert users, and municipality. The monitoring tools facilitate the monitoring of the effectiveness of the solution implemented in the city, providing objective data and the representation of the key performance indicator. Technical tools, instead, are a set of back-end tools that are devoted to support the that are devoted to cover the possible gaps in the data and the interoperability issues that could occur during the integration, as example of ICT sensors and the online services. The ICT framework is based and totally implemented, exploiting open source license and standard technologies. It is fully compliant with the standard for the interoperability at European level, as example CF. And OASC principle. These permit to ensure that no vendor lock-in, no technological lock-in, and as a consequence, it permit to reduce the cost for maintaining the architecture, but also for any other adaptation and extension in the future. Feature for multimodal data visualization permit to create easy to understand interactive dashboards that permit to represent, as example, the KPI, and the feature for data management and data collection from heterogeneous data sources permit to connect the already existing infrastructure in the city. So in this way, we can connect together the IoT devices and the open data portal and also the online web service. The whole ICT framework is derived by the digital enabler, that is the digital transformation platform provided by engineering. Let's see the tool in detail. The first one is the Open Nature Innovation Arena, namely ONIA. This tool makes the municipalities able to collect the feedback from the citizens in form of challenges that are a kind of open call for action. The citizens can collaborate and can submit their problems affecting the city, and also can propose possible solution in form of idea. This tool support the social cohesion and facilitate and enable the stakeholder management, and also provide a transparent idea selection. This in order to ensure the accountability and the transparency from the municipality point of view. City Performance Monitor, namely CPM, is the tool that supports the monitoring of the effectiveness, the impact of the MBS in the city. The tool facilitates the understanding of the key indicators also for not expert users via a set of interfaces representing a set of simplified indicators and easy to understand the charts, graph, and graphical representation. The tool leverages on the actual data coming from the data sources connected to the ICT infrastructure, and also permit to set up the formula for the automatic KPI calculation. These permit to reduce the burden of the activities from the municipality point of view, because it is automatic calculation. The MBS simulation visualization tool, instead, is another tool that increase the awareness about the urban environment condition and the effectiveness of the MBS already implemented. It provides possibility to compare the current situation in the city with the possible changes derived by the implementation of MBS. As you can see, we have two maps where the indicators level are represented using a standard color code. Then using these easy to understand interfaces, it is possible to enable the collaboration and the interaction between different kind of stakeholders from the expert view, from the expert users to the common citizens and not expert users. We already developed all the models for Eindhoven City. Tampere and Genova are nearing to completion, and the University of Aveiro in Portugal is also completing the models, the missing models. So we are collaborating with them. Maria, do you want to illustrate the adaptive management cycle?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Saverio. So once Saverio has told us about all the tools that were developed in UNaLab, we can place them in their respective places in the adaptive management cycle, which is a core principle in NBS planning and implementation. So Saverio, could you please summarize the role of each tool?
Yes. Okay. We saw the tools as independent tool, but during the adaptive management cycle, the tools permit the stakeholder involvement in different phases. In fact, during the plan phase, the Open Innovation Area, MBS SVT, City Performance Monitor permit to highlight, to identify possible disruption in the city, as example, via the indicators that could be out of the scale, or they can inspire possible solution through the MBS simulation and visualization tool. Then using the ONIA, the citizen can notify the problems from their point of view. During the do phase, ONIA and MBS SVT will support the stakeholders on the identification of the root causes of the problem and on co-defining the possible solution in form of idea. During the check-in phase, instead, stakeholders continue to collaborate to be involved in the process using City Performance Monitor and ONIA. Then they can monitor the effectiveness of the solution under implementation, and in case of possible disruption, they can notify the problems or a possible adaptment in form of idea. These will be provided as input for the act and adjust phase. That will is the phase where the solution will be put in the in practice in the real environment to be fine-tuned or for continuous improvement. Then this is the last step of the process, but it is also a cycle. So in this way, the process will start again, and then the stakeholders can discuss how to maintain the good condition and the quality of life in the city, and how to improve this condition. Now we can open the question.
Super, thank you so much, both of you.
I think that we are in time.
We have some 10 minutes left for questions. So any of the participants, you just unmute yourself or and enable your video and audio, and then you can join us and ask a question. Maybe while the participants are thinking about a good question for you, I have one. Could you, were these ICT tools tested already in cities, or are they already being applied in some cities, and what have the results been so far? Or experience?
Yes, we have been testing all the tools in the pilots in the city of Genova, Tampere, and Doven. The city of Tampere completed the first iteration of the implementation, providing data sources and providing all the models required to start the monitoring activities. City of Eindhoven and Genova are nearing to the completion. They already provided some data sources that permitted to collect actual values from the real environment, but only for a subset of indicators. During the next week, they will release additional API that will be connected to the ICT infrastructure in order to augment the number of indicators available for the monitoring phase.
Thank you. Anybody else would like to ask a question to Maria and Piersaverio? I would also like to know, often I have made the experience that in cities and municipalities, they have got quite a strict also like data regulations and etc. So have you encountered any difficulties like this to implement this like framework in the cities, and how have you dealt with it?
Yeah, we encountered some difficulties due to the internal regulation, but fortunately we are talking about open data, so for the monitoring activities, it is enough to have a kind of open data source, and the features provided by the interoperability framework within the ICT infrastructure is able to connect any kind of data sources to the infrastructure. I see the question from Martin. As I said, the ICT infrastructure ensure the no city lock-in and the no vendor lock-in. This thanks to the implementation of features basing on standard protocols and open libraries. This permit to port the already implemented features from one city to another city without any difficulties. We can do it very easily. The whole framework has been designed considering the interoperability principle. So all the features are not implemented only for a specific city. Thus, we can add additional pilot, or we can have an independent installation of the ICT infrastructure. So it is not a problem. In fact, we already ensured our viability to support, in addition to the front runner city in the UNaLab project, also the viability for the follower city that would like to join the architecture.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for answering this question. Anybody else, you can either join us in the panel or you can also write in the chat if you prefer. We have time for a last question. I have a lot of questions because I feel that this framework is huge that you have developed with so many components, and I guess every component could be discussed in a separate session.
You're right.
You are right. Yes, this because the components provide several facilitation for the stakeholders and differentiate the role along the life cycle. So we can say that this is only a very short overview about the infrastructure. I would also highlight that the architecture is composed of modules, so we can deploy an architecture that permit to cover the actual needs of each pilot. It is not necessary to deploy the whole architecture, but we can also design, we can also deploy a smaller architecture in order to support the specific need of the city or the customer.
Okay. How much okay, so we have one last question from Laura Wendling, and she would like to know how OPLA connects to UNIA.
Yes, we are in collaboration with OPLA. We are defining the European metadata catalog, interoperable metadata catalog for the MBS description. We already implemented the infrastructure in the OPLA side and connected the API in order to provide a description of the MBS already implemented in the city and inspire possible idea in the citizens. So the Open NATO Innovation Arena now is able to allow the searching in the MBS metadata catalog. In addition to this, the ideas and the challenges can be associated to the MBS in order to start the discussion and inspire the municipality, or in order to provide an indication to the expert users that will be able to define better the idea in form of MBS.
Okay, thank you. Thank you both. Thank you very much for sharing this experience with us. And and thank you all the participants for joining the Innovation Cafes. They finish now, and we invite you to join our next session called Building Natural Networks and Delivering the Deal with Stakeholders. I invite you to join our main stage again now. Take care and have a good time.